Hello, everybody. Not just my tripod a little bit here. Maybe too much. Confidence as I'm drawing, and I'm gonna start with this. It's an excerpt from Kayla Leah Rich's book, The Purple Crayon Confidence. And this is just in the introduction, people. I see you. Even though part of you doesn't want to be seen, I see you. I would write your name, but I don't want to put you on the spot. I see you feeling insignificant, insecure, unworthy, invisible. I see you. I see that you are beat up from what life has dished out. I see you are tired, struggling to want to fight the fight another day. Hiding does have its comfort. Besides, you may rationalize that you don't have much to offer, but I see you. I see the amazing you shrinking away from filling the full measure of your creation. I see you and my insides ache for you. I want so bad, almost enough for both of us, for you to see the teeniest glimpse of who you really are. The power and brilliance and you-ness that you are hiding inside you. I would think you selfish. Selfish for shrinking, selfish for hiding all your amazingness, for not sharing with the world the flavor that only you can bring, for holding back, denying us of your best self. But that wouldn't be right. I know your intention isn't to be selfish, though selfishness is the result. You are keeping all your wonderfulness to yourself, but I worry that even you don't enjoy you. So that's from Kaylalea's, that's just the introduction piece. Purple Crayon Confidence. And I'm working my way through that right now. Gonna adjust my light a little bit here. And then get started drawing while I'm talking. Come on, light. There go. Got some funny shadows. Oh well. It is what it is. So, for those who don't know me, I am Jessica Tookey. I am an artist, and mental health advocate, I guess I would consider myself, suicide prevention advocate. Just learned to work with both hands at the same time, learned that I could even draw with my left hand just last year. So last April was the first drawing with my left hand, and then May was the first with both hands at the same time. And then this talking while I'm drawing is brand new, just couple weeks ago. So, the drawings typically all when I, especially when I'm talking, I'm going with the easiest thing for me, so you'll see what it is soon. Anyway, talking about confidence today, and it's really super important for everyone to have confidence, but specifically artists. And that goes for writers, authors, artists of all kinds, performing artists, because if you don't have the confidence, you are not gonna cut it. Because as soon as somebody says, "Oh, your stuff isn't what I'm looking for," it can be really crushing if you don't have it in mind that you gave them the opportunity to participate in your greatness and they chose not to. So that's the mindset that I've been working in for the past 2 years. My first rejection to a show was kind of hurtful because it was the first rejection. And He's already working on shifting the way that I thought about things and thought about just life in general. And so it was just hurtful for a very brief moment, and then I realized, oh, well, that's okay. I gave them the opportunity to enjoy my work. They chose not to. And for those of you who are just seeing me for the first time, this is just a quick sketch. I do very, very detailed work as well. So I have a lot of different styles, I guess, different types of work, not really styles, but types of things that I do. Anyway, I gave them the opportunity to experience my stuff. They chose not to take it, and I went, something else is coming. That's the reason that I couldn't participate in this thing. And sure enough, within that week, I had an invitation for something that I didn't even know was happening, and they wanted me there. Their words were, improve the aesthetics of their event. So, super cool. And if you can just get yourself into that mindset of confidence and knowing that you have greatness within you, and you have a light and a gift that you are meant to share with people, then you'll be able to do absolutely anything. So, I've been at least displayed confidence my entire lifetime. I remember growing up when my parents would be, when we were at the bowling alley, for example, my brother and sister would want me to go get the shoes, or want me to go get the food, or whatever the case may be. I was the one that was always just going and doing it, because I wasn't afraid to just do it. And so, that's how I came across to everyone, but inside I was really uncomfortable with myself and uncomfortable with who I was supposed to be really uncomfortable with this that was very much a tomboy, and I just didn't ever want to fit the norms, and knew I was an artist, but everyone in my life was saying, "Oh, that, yeah, that's a good hobby, but what are you gonna do for a real job?" So I struggled, even though I exuded confidence, I really struggled my entire life and have actually struggled with suicidal thoughts, ideation, and it's been something that I have worked through and thankfully not gone through with any of the plans that have come up throughout my lifetime. And there was always something that held me here, and so I'm hoping that through my art now I can help people find their purpose and find something that will help keep them here, because suicide is definitely not the option. You have not you have something to share with the world, and if you're having suicidal thoughts, then it's most likely confidence that needs to be improved, and just love of self. So, anyway, that's a little of my childhood and past. But now that I have stepped out into my gift, I am feeling complete, I guess you could say.